Before embarking on the journey of structured expert judgment and decision-making under uncertainty, we need to first formulate a clear and workable point of view about uncertainty itself. In this video, we will talk about the meaning of uncertainty and its interpretation and representation in the context of expert judgment. Saying that uncertainty is whatever disappears when we become certain, it's both true and funny. But it is hardly enough for the task we need to undertake, namely quantifying the uncertainty. For such a task, we will employ a mathematical representation of uncertainty, which requires a set of axioms, interpretations, and measurement procedures. The axioms will specify formal properties of uncertainty, and the interpretations, also called operational definitions, will connect the terms in these axioms with observable, measurable phenomena. While different formalisms for encoding uncertainty numerically are proposed, none has the power, axiomatic and empirical validity of probability theory. Hence, we choose the probability formalism as the perfect tool for representing uncertainty. There are three probability axioms, also called Kolmogorov axioms, which formulate mathematical properties of the probability of events to occur. An event A, for example, it will rain tomorrow, may or may not occur. The probability of this event's occurrence is denoted by P of A, and it is a number between 0 and 1. The complement of event A, it will not rain tomorrow, will then happen with probability 1 minus the P of A. The third axiom considers disjoint events. Disjoint events are events that cannot happen at the same time. The probability of the union of such events is the sum of the event's probabilities. Two of the most used and useful interpretations of probabilities are the objective or frequency interpretation and the subjective or Bayesian interpretation. In the frequency interpretation, probability is defined in terms of randomness, that is, as limiting relative frequency in random sequences. In the subjective interpretation, probability is defined in terms of the degree of belief of a rational individual. Many types of uncertainty have been distinguished, but an in-depth discussion about these is out of the scope. For the present discussion, it is enough to mention the most frequently used types of uncertainty, the epistemic and the aleatory uncertainty, and to stress the fact that these are quantifiable by subjective probabilities. Aleatory uncertainty is the natural variability, whereas the epistemic uncertainty is the lack of knowledge. Both types can be quantified by experts. Before diving into what it is that we are asking the experts about, let us remember that from events and experiments, we can construct random variables. And these are simply links between the set of events and the set of numbers. An event A, it will rain tomorrow, can be associated with a value 1. And its complement, it will not rain tomorrow, can be associated with 0. In this way, we construct what is called a discrete, binary, random variable, which can take value 1 with probability p and value 0 with probability 1 minus p. It is the value of p that we can then elicit from experts. However, we may be interested to know more details about the rain phenomenon, rather than just the binary information and its respective probabilities. When the information we require is measured on a continuous scale, we talk of continuous random variables and their distributions, which associate a probability function to all values of such variables. There are many parametric continuous probability functions that can be used to model the phenomenon of interest, but unfortunately, we won't have time to talk about them in this video. Instead, I'll show you several examples of such functions used to model the southeastern United States summer rainfall in 2009. The red curve in this figure corresponds to the daily precipitation measured in millimeters in the summer of 2009. Several models for this phenomenon are also presented to give an indication of what parametric model would represent a good fit for the data. The authors of this study present a mixture of normals, a gamma, a viable, and an exponential distribution for comparison. These curves are the probability density functions which associate probabilities to very small neighborhoods around all the values on the x-axis. When the data are absent, we turn to experts for the quantification of such curves. But what is it that we are going to ask the experts to estimate in this case? In the discrete case, we asked for probabilities of certain values of the variable. But can you imagine the same exercise for continuous curves? Neither do I. Instead of asking probabilities of certain values, we are going to let the experts tell us what values correspond to certain probabilities. That is, we are going to ask for quantiles of a distribution. Not all quantiles, but a finite number of them, enough to be able to then construct the distribution function from the limited information. To refresh your memory, the p% quantile is the value, little x, of the variable capital X for which the probability that the variable X is less than little x equals p divided by 100. In expert elicitations, we fix p and we ask the experts to estimate the corresponding little x. For instance, the median of a distribution is the 50% quantile. When experts are asked for their best estimate of a variable, their best estimate is then modeled as the median of the distribution of that variable. The median is the value for which the expert judges that it is as likely for the variable to be above x as it is for the variable to be below x. If the experts were asked to choose whether to bet on the variable is less than or equal little x or on the variable is larger than or equal to little x, they should have no preference. Going back to the example of the southeastern United States summer rainfall in 2009 and isolating one of the curves from the figure you have seen three slides ago, the vertical line on this graph corresponds to the median and it sits around value 3. It is this value that we are asking our experts about. However, the median value alone would not give us enough information to build an entire distribution. For this reason, we are going to ask for more quantiles. And to make sure we capture less central behavior of this variable, we are going to ask about more extreme quantiles. The simplest option is to ask for a lower quantile and for an upper quantile. This will form a credible range. We could, for instance, ask for the 5% quantile as the lower quantile and for the 95% quantile as the upper quantile. A 90% credible interval will be then obtained. It means that the experts think that there is still a 10% chance for the real value of the variable to fall outside the interval they have created, namely in one of the two blue shaded areas of this graph. Together with the median, we could elicit other upper and lower quantiles. We may ask for the 10% quantile and the 90% quantile, hence forming an 80% credible interval. Instead, we may choose to ask for a 25% and a 75% quantiles, forming a 50% credible interval. These choices are influenced by many factors, among which the nature of the phenomenon, the complexity of the problem, the familiarity of the experts with probabilistic concepts and certain question formats, etc. Thank you for your attention.